The trend of murder cases in Gulu City is shifting from land conflict to domestic violence. This follows the revelations by the Uganda police force that two women are in their custody for allegedly murdering their husbands. One of the cases involves a renowned lawyer and former Peche Division counselor, Amony Francesca, who is the main suspect in the murder by stabbing of her husband, Dr. Etuk Joseph, on Friday night.
Yes, we have the suspect in custody at Gulu West Division cells. That is, of course, one Amony Francesca. We have so far recorded statements from relevant witnesses to help us in investigation. However, for her as the suspect, psychologically she's still a bit traumatized.
From social media videos and photos, Amony Francesca and the late Dr. Etuk Joseph looked like a very happy couple. In one of the videos, they are hugging, while in another, the late is seen handing her a wreath of flowers. In a Facebook post in July 2022, the late doctor promises to love Francesca till his dying day. However, the suspected murder of Dr. Etuk Joseph as a result of a domestic misunderstanding has shocked everyone in the city.
Women have to be encouraged. We encourage you women outside there, come to the church, join the women group, and let's trust God together and pray. As the Bible says, that our battle is not against flesh and blood.
The late sustained deep cuts to the right side of the rib cage and on the head. The murder comes at a time when medical experts are recording 400 mental illness cases every week in Gulu City since August 2022.
Of recent, there is high rise of cases of depression in women as a result of difficult situations at home. You find one man with four or five wives not providing enough for the whole family just because of hard economic situation affects women much more than anything else. We are almost through the one quarter of this financial year. The number appears to be bigger, at least by around 10% bigger than what we had last in the last quarter.
These are alarming figures. As of October 2021, Gulu Regional Referral Hospital was recording only 100 cases every week. The rise in cases is being associated with hard economic times. Emmy Ochen, the Gulu City West Border chairperson, says men have become the main victims of domestic violence.
Sensitize the wife and husband who are in the family so that we see how we can reduce this matter. Because when the home is okay, everything is okay, such a thing will not happen. For me, I also have the witness. Sometimes women of my border rider, they always come to my office. We find that the husband has abandoned them for 3 months.
Furthermore, while speaking to Urban TV on Monday afternoon, the Achua River Region police spokesperson, Ongom David Mudong, revealed that Amony Francesca has failed to record a statement due to a breakdown in her mental health.
We really encourage people with domestic related matters to walk when doors are open at the police, and we offer them counseling. We have departments.
In 2017, Amony Francesca, who by then was serving as the Peche Division counselor, was convicted for burning her maid using a flat iron.
Could be just a slight fight, maybe slap here and there, but because she's weak, she knows the woman, the man may kill, and then she will get the whole of things and hit at once. Technical knockout, maybe kicking or hitting with a hammer just to kill, because she knows she cannot defend herself in fighting. So let's go, come to church.
The other suspected cases involving the murder of spouses in Gulu City in the recent past include Awan Oroma Jennifer, and another involving a Gulu University student, Achayo Agnes, who was allegedly hacked to death by her 50-year-old boyfriend, Alfred Ochan.
Now, right now we are having murders as a result of domestic violence.
So we studied this. We studied the trend and what is actually causing it. And where time allows, we usually go out to the public and we sensitize them on how best they can handle some of these issues.
Men are being encouraged to report domestic violence cases and admit that they need marriage counseling.
The shift in cases has been attributed to economic hardships. But now there is a need for a general sensitization on all media and platforms that are available through the cultural institutions. Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.